Oh boy, the new iOS beta is out. Should you install it? How do you do it? Is it safe? Is it stable? Let's answer those questions. So to get the stuff you probably don't want to hear out of the way right away, no, you probably shouldn't install a beta profile on your phone. Unless you're technical, you're okay with potentially having a phone that's riddled with bugs, or you have a second phone that you just want to play around with, I would not recommend installing the beta profile to pretty much anybody. Betas are exactly what they sound like. It's a pre-release of software. In this case, Apple is using developers to help test the new copy of their software to see if it's viable. They hunt down bugs, they expect it to be problems, they have logging turned all the way up high, which means that your phone's going to probably use more battery. There's a plethora of reasons why you might want to stay away from the beta profiles. But if you're okay with the fact that your phone is probably going to be unstable and unreliable and maybe even burn through battery, then yeah, try it out. Playing with beta profiles can be a lot of fun, especially if you like to tweak your phone, get ahead of the curve, talk to your friends about all the new features that are coming out. It's a really good way to get your feet wet with the new software that hasn't even been released yet to the general public. That being said, at the time of this video, it's June 9th, the public beta profile has not been released yet. Typically, those are a little safer for consumption by the public, but the developer profiles can be a little bit more buggy, especially early on in the beta like this. So consider this your warning. If you're unsure of what your answer is, the answer is probably no. If you have a phone that you rely on heavily or you're not okay with having be a little faulty, your answer should be no. Now, with all that out of the way, the first thing you need to do is take a backup. Plug your phone into your computer, take a good backup. It's the only way to get back to a good known working of iOS should you have a problem. Once your backup is complete, you're going to want to head over to betaprofiles.com, click on iOS 16, then click Install Profile and follow the prompts. It's going to install a profile on your phone that tells your phone to get iOS 16 when it's looking for updates. The webpage also walks you through all the instructions as well. Then you're going to want to go to Settings, pull down to show the search field, and type in Profiles. Click on VPN and Device Management, and then click on iOS 16 Beta Profile. It's going to ask if you want to install on the top right. Click that. Type in your password. Read all this material, click Install Anyway, and then click Restart. Then once your phone restarts, you'll be able to go download the latest version of iOS. Now that you've finished downloading, go back to Settings, click General, click on Software Update, and you should now see iOS 16 ready for download. You're basically going to click Download and Install, and then follow the instructions on the screen. Thank you so much for stopping by the channel today and checking out this video with me. If you end up installing the iOS 16 beta profile, let me know what you think of it in the comments below. If you liked the video, hit that thumbs up. If not, the thumbs down works as well. And as always, I appreciate the subscription. Peace.